Continuing on with our inverse trigonometric ratios worksheet on the KutaSoftware website, we'll pick up with number 15, which is the first problem on the second page. Our directions are to find the measure of the indicated angle to the nearest degree. So for 15, our indicated angle, let's call that x. So remembering SOHCAHTOA, sine equals opposite over adjacent, cosine equals adjacent over hypotenuse, and tangent equals opposite over adjacent. So the side lengths relating to angle x, the opposite side length is 12, and the hypotenuse is 24. So having opposite and hypotenuse, we're going to be using sine. The sine of x is equal to the opposite side length, 12, over 24. So we're going to take the inverse sine of both sides in order to isolate our angle. The inverse sine of the sine of x is equal to the inverse sine of 12 over 24, where 12 24ths is within parentheses. So essentially, we're not taking the inverse sine of 12 and then dividing that by 24. We're taking the inverse sine of the entire quantity, 12 divided by 24. So the inverse sine of the sine of x is x, and that's equal to the inverse sine of 12 over 24. Making sure our calculator is in degree mode, since we're looking for the nearest degree, we're going to type the inverse sine of 12 divided by 24, which is 30. So 30 degrees is our indicated angle x. In number 16, here, let's call this angle y. We're not given the opposite side, we're given the adjacent side, and we're also given the hypotenuse. So since we're given adjacent and hypotenuse, we're going to be using cosine. The cosine of angle y is equal to the adjacent side of 13 over the hypotenuse of 20. So now we're going to take the inverse cosine of both sides. So the inverse cosine of the cosine of y is that angle y, and the inverse cosine of 13 over 20 we'll type into our calculator to get 49.4, which will round down to 49. So y is equal to 49 degrees. So 49 degrees is our indicated angle. In number 17, let's call this angle A. For A, we're given the side that's adjacent to A, and we're given the side that is the hypotenuse of the right triangle. So adjacent over hypotenuse, we're going to be using cosine. Think ka. So the cosine of A equals the adjacent side 6 over the hypotenuse of 8. Taking the inverse cosine of both sides, we'll get that A is equal to the inverse cosine of 6 over 8, which is equal to 41.4, which will round to 41 degrees. So A is 41 degrees in number 17. And number 18, let's call this angle B. For angle B, we're not given the opposite side. However, we're given the adjacent side, and we're given the hypotenuse, since that's directly across from 90 degrees. So for this, we're also going to be using cosine. The cosine of angle B is equal to the adjacent side length of 4 over the hypotenuse of 5. So we'll take the inverse cosine of both sides of our equation. Because remember, whatever we do to the left, we need to do to the right. The inverse cosine cancels out with the cosine, so we'll have b remaining on our left-hand side, and the inverse cosine of 4 divided by 5 will give us 36.8. So that will be equivalent, when we round, to 37 degrees. So b, our indicated angle in number 18, is 37 degrees. For 19, let's call this angle x. We're given the side opposite x, the side adjacent to x, and we're also given the hypotenuse. So we're going to be able to choose what we want to use. We can use sine, cosine, or tangent. And for number 19, I'll use two different trig functions to show you that they are all equivalent. So I'm going to do the cosine of x, and I'm also going to do the sine of x. So feel free to do the tangent of x and leave in the comments below what you get as your answer. Hint, it should be the same as what I get for cosine and sine. So the cosine of x, we're going to be using adjacent over hypotenuse. So that's 48 over 50. And for sine, opposite over hypotenuse is 14 over 50. So taking the inverse sine of both sides, in my bottom equation, I'll get that x is equal to the inverse sine of 14 over 50. The inverse sine of 14 over 50 is 16.26, which will round to 16. So x is 16 degrees. Let's double check that using cosine. The cosine of x will take the inverse cosine of both sides. Taking the inverse cosine of both sides, we'll get that x is equal to the inverse cosine of 48 over 50. So the inverse cosine of 48 over 50 should give us what we got for x using sine, and again, 16.26, which will round to 16 degrees. So our answer for x in number 19 is 16 degrees. In number 20, again, we're given all three side lengths of the triangle. So let's call this angle A. And since we didn't use tangent in the last problem, let's use tangent here. So tangent is opposite side over the adjacent side. So the tangent of A is equal to the opposite side of 68 over the adjacent side of 51. Taking the inverse tangent of both sides, I'll get that A is equal to the inverse tangent of 68 over 51. The inverse tangent of 68 over 51 equals 53.13, so 53 degrees. So our answer in number 20 is 53 degrees. And that is angle that's indicated. In number 21, let's call this angle B, and let's use sine. So the sine of B, remember, opposite over hypotenuse. Opposite is 24 over a hypotenuse of 25. So the inverse sine of the sine of B equals the inverse sine of 24 over 25. So inverse sine of 24 over 25 equals 73.7, which will round to 74 degrees. And number 22, I'll use cosine. So the cosine of our missing angle, let's call this x, is equal to adjacent 30 over hypotenuse 34. So the inverse cosine of the cosine of x is equal to the inverse cosine of 30 over 34. So x is equal to 28.0 degrees, which rounds to 28 degrees. So x is 28 degrees for number 22. In number 23, I'll use tangent. The tangent of our missing angle y is equal to opposite over adjacent. Opposite is 51 over adjacent, which is 68. And remember that adjacent is the side that helps form that angle, but is not the hypotenuse. Taking the inverse tangent of both sides, I'll get that y is equal to the inverse tangent of 51 over 68. So the inverse tangent of 51 over 68 will give me 36.8, which rounds to 37 degrees. So 37 degrees is my solution in number 23. And lastly, for this set of directions, number 24, I'll use sine. And we'll call this angle x. So the sine of x is equal to the opposite side of 42 over the hypotenuse of 70. So the inverse sine of the sine of x is x, and the inverse sine of 42 over 70, typing that into our calculators, we'll get 36.8, which will round to 37 degrees. Now, onto our critical thinking questions. In number 25, it says, find an angle x where the sine of x equals the cosine of x. So the sine, remember, is the opposite side length over the hypotenuse, and that's equal to the cosine of x, which is the adjacent side length over the hypotenuse. So essentially, we're saying that the opposite side is going to be equal to the adjacent side. So the legs of the triangle are congruent. And if the legs are congruent in a 90 degree angle, we know that the angles are congruent. So that's going to be a 45, 45, 90 triangle. So the sine of x, the sine of 45 degrees, is equal to the cosine of 45 degrees. And go ahead and type that into your calculator, and you'll see if you do the sine of 45 degrees, you get 0.707, and the cosine of 45 degrees, you also get 0.707. And number 26, we're to draw and label all three sides of a right triangle that has a 40 degree angle and a hypotenuse of 10 centimeters. So here I've drawn our right triangle. We're given that our hypotenuse is 10 centimeters. And we have one angle that's 40 degrees. So I'll make this angle 40 degrees. Now knowing that that angle's 40 degrees, let's start by solving for the side opposite 40 degrees. So if we're looking for the side length opposite 40 degrees, we're going to be using sine. So the sine of 40 degrees is going to be equal to that opposite side length, which we do not know. Let's call that opposite side length x. So that opposite side length x over our hypotenuse of 10 centimeters. Now we need to isolate x to figure out what that length is. So we'll multiply both sides by 10. Multiplying both sides by 10, I'll get my x all by itself, and I'll need to multiply 10 to the sine of 40 degrees. And the sine of 40 degrees is 0.6427 or 0.643. So 0.643 times 10 will be 6.43. So I'll just round that to 6.4. And remember, we're talking about centimeters, so this side length is 6.4 centimeters. Now we need to find this other side length. Let's call that y. And we can do this a few different ways. One way we can do it is by using the Pythagorean theorem. We have one side length and the hypotenuse, so we can solve for the other side length. However, I want to use a trig function. So y, we can see, is the adjacent side of 40 degrees. So instead of using sine, I'm going to use cosine. So the cosine of 40 degrees is equal to the adjacent side y over our hypotenuse of 10. So again, we'll multiply both sides by 10 in order to isolate our side length, and that in this case is y. So we're going to do 10 times the cosine of 40 degrees. That's going to be equal to y. And the cosine of 40 degrees is 0.766. So 0.766 times 10 will give us 7.66, which I'll round to 7.7. And we're talking in terms of centimeters, so that's 7.7 centimeters. And that's our answer for number 26. Note, we could have also figured out this angle using the triangle sum theorem and then used sine to solve for y, or use cosine with that angle to solve for x. So there's many different ways to go about solving number 26. If you want to double check, try a couple of the other ways I suggested and see if you get the same answer. Now, if you found this video helpful, please subscribe to my channel. That way you're updated when I come out with new videos. And also like this video so that I know that you found it useful. Also, if you have any comments, leave them below and I'll get back to you as soon as I can.